The Westgate Tunnel project will create one of Melbourne's longest road tunnels with a combined length of over 6 kilometres. There's a lot involved, so let's find out how it's built. The tunnel boring machines, named Bella and Vida, are currently the largest in the Southern Hemisphere, at 15.6 metres wide, and were custom designed in Germany by Herrenknecht. They are assembled and lowered into the launch site at Footscray by the Maribyrnong River. They then dig the twin tunnels, heading south towards the Westgate Freeway. The outbound tunnel rises on the east side of Miller's Road, with the inbound tunnel diving just before Williamstown Road and coming out at Footscray. Tim is the manager on the project and takes us through the digging process.
Our tunnels on the Westgate Tunnel project will go as low as 40 metres below ground. We're using earth pressure TBMs. Those push the ground around the TBM out in all directions. Obviously, we've got a large cutter head at the front of the TBM. That's churning away, cutting the rock away. A screw press inside the TBM moves the material onto the conveyor and then into the bin itself.
After the soil is excavated, the tunnel borers immediately lift into place concrete segments that are produced at our purpose-built precast concrete facility in Benalla. The borers pick up the concrete and use it to line the walls of the tunnels. It takes 10 concrete segments to make one complete ring, but in the end, we'll have about 25,000 lining the walls of the tunnels. There are crews working 24/7 in the TBMs as they tunnel.
One of the main things that we do as engineers is to make sure that all the systems are in place for our construction teams to actually do the work. We have to liaise between designers and what actually goes in the construction of the tunnel on a day-to-day basis to make sure that we're on track and that we're actually doing a good job and safe job, both inside the tunnel and also that we don't have any impacts on surface.
The tunneling will require the removal of 1.5 million cubic metres of rock and soil. Andrew guides us through how this is managed.
Excavated rock and soil is moved via a conveyor system to our purpose-built tunnelling hub. The rock and soil we excavate building the Westgate tunnels is mixed with substances to form a paste so it can be easily transported from our tunnel boring machines to the hub. From massive bins within the shed, the soil is loaded into trucks to be taken away and safely disposed of at a purpose-built facility in Buller. Every truck used to transport spoil complies with the EPA requirements. They are covered with a PVC cover. The trucks are also sealed at the back by a rubber compression seal, tailgate locks, and grain locks to prevent leakage from the backs of the trailers. Before they leave our site, the trucks are washed to remove any dirt, weighed, and as a final measure, their cleanliness is checked before they hit the road. Our trucks are GPS tracked to ensure routes are adhered to and minimise travel through residential areas.
The tunnels will be finished off with fit-out, road deck, lane markings, and freeway management systems before opening to the public. The benefits will be enormous, transforming Melbourne's west with a quicker, safer, and more direct route to and from the city.